guys, how are you doing? I got some good news and I got some bad news, and I'll start off with the bad news. The bad news is regarding to my external hard drive, which failed on me. I talked about that in my previous video. There is a possibility that all the data is retrievable from my external hard drive and to put on a new external hard drive. There are some companies that are able to do this. In the best case, it costs a few hundred euros, and in the worst case, they have to do a clean room data recovery. That means they're going into a white suit, into a dust-free clean room. They open up the hard drive, try to get all the data and put it on a new hard drive. So that cost 800-900 euros. So I'm gonna give my external hard drive to a company, ask them what they think I need to do with this, and then ask them for a price. Then I will make a pot, save some money, and I'll, you know, by the time I've got enough money, I'll just try to see if they can get my data off my external hard drive. So that might take a while. So all the Malta Death Fest footage and the bands that have not been, well, broadcast on my channel yet, it's gonna take a while. It may take a long while, because 800-900 euros is not saved by that. So that's the bad news. There's still a chance that I can get my data back, but we'll just have to wait and see how that develops and how long that takes. So sorry guys, I can't. I was dumb enough to put everything on an external hard drive and not on a separate place too. A friend of mine who also built my computer told me, like, you always need two different places, your computer and an external hard drive. And if your drive fails, you still have your shit on your computer or some sort of backup somewhere. You always need multiple places. And I was like, yeah. I'm a plasterer, not a computer expert. You know, I'm just glad I can make these videos and go on the internet and write a letter on a computer, and I already felt tough enough, you know. And when he said it, I was like, yeah, sounds logical, actually. I mean, another example. I had no house phone. I mean, I got my mobile phone, but I also have a house phone for 2 months, and I was like, fuck. And we bought a new house phone and it didn't work, and I called up the company that provides my my phone connection, and I was like, fuck you, just connect my goddamn phone. And they were like, the connection is fine, there's nothing wrong. And I was searching for the router and the PC and everything, and I was like, oh. 2 months. I left it for 2 months. Then Yusei went on a holiday for a week with her parents, and I had to work, so I couldn't go. And I was like, you know what, I'll just go and see if I can fix the phone one more time. So I went to my router, because my phone is connected to my router, and all of a sudden I see that in my router there were two entries for the cable of the phone. And my phone was in router entry number two, and I was like, maybe I can see if it fits in router number or entry number one. So I took it out, pushed it in, and the phone worked. Just like those computer problems I had, I told my friend who came over, I said, like, I don't see anything. And he was like, well, okay, let's start up the computer. And he pushed the start button, and he listened. Computer spinned. Well, you know, it spins on the inside. It starts to work. And he heard the Windows tune. Doo-doo-doo. And I was like, it's broken. I don't see anything. And he was like, well, have you considered the fact that it might be your screen? And I was like, no, that can't be. I mean, I just bought it new and should be okay, right? So he brought a new screen with a different cable. And long story short, it was the cable that went from my screen to the computer. That thing was broken. So I had 2 weeks no, just a regular computer because of that cable. And I was just dumb enough to figure that out. I'm not a technician, really. Just anyway, the good news is that I have a very good band for you guys. This is the first promo of this year, and I kept it a little bit close to home. These guys are from the Netherlands, and they're called Bodyfarm. These guys are from the Netherlands, and they're called Bodyfarm. Baldrick!
What?
Baldrick, you were supposed to start the music as soon as I said Bodyfarm, remember?
Yeah, now you said it.
No, I already said it, Baldrick.
Are you sure?
Alright, wait. We're gonna do this one more time. As soon as I say Bodyfarm, you start the music. Alright?
Roger.
Wait. What?
As soon as I say Bodyfarm,
Bodyfarm!
Your filthy life has ended here. Your 6 feet underground. Maggots will devour you till this all rebounds. Your face so pale, your skin so cold. You never got old. Your parents cried because you died. They should have died.
Anyway, just like I said, these guys are from the Netherlands and they're called Bodyfarm. And I met their vocalist Thomas Wouters a while ago at a gig in Rotterdam, and I believe it was the Baruch, that's the venue, during Deicide. I'm not sure anymore. Anyway, I was checking out the merchandise and I had a beer, and there were a few other people that also were like, hey, you're from YouTube, and I was like, yes, bye. No, that's not the way I react, but Thomas also came up to me and he was like, hey, aren't you the guy from the videos from YouTube? And I was like, who's this clown? But anyway, we started talking, and in this conversation he was like, you know, if you're interested, I'm in a band. And I was like, I'm not. But anyway, he gave me this carton version of a promo, EP, demo, whatever you want to call it. And I'll just show it to you guys. This is the front, and that's the Bodyfarm logo. It looks pretty cool. It has 5 songs on it, and even a MySpace site, myspace.com/bodyfarmNL. NL is Holland, the Netherlands. I mean, who still has MySpace these days? I mean, we all stepped over to Facebook, and not that that's really great with all their advertisement shit and your comment bar asking, how do you feel, Ed? Ooh, you know? Just, yeah. Until there's something better, and then we'll just, we're sheep. You know, we all go to Facebook, and then when there's something better than Facebook, we'll just follow each other over the gate. Maybe my ex was right that we had ghosts. Well, anyway, as I came home, I dropped it on my desk, and after 2 weeks, I found it again, and I was like, oh shit, that's the carton cover from Bodyfarm, from Thomas. And you never know what to expect, because I get a lot more from these things, carton covers, and with just a couple of songs. And in a lot of cases, it's just recorded in a garage with a mobile phone or a very bad camera, and I was a little bit afraid that this was the same shit. Anyway, I put it in my CD player and I was like, this is actually really, really good. I think Bodyfarm is really good and they play a very good version of old school death metal.
This war is making you
little while later, Thomas sent me a message on Facebook, and already became dark outside. It's winter, it gets dark so fucking fast, so that's why I got some extra light. He sent me a message on Facebook asking me if I was interested in making Bodyfarm a video. And I was like, yeah, sure, you guys got a video clip on YouTube, which is really cool, which I will also use in this video. I've got a carton cover with a few songs on it, and I will use pictures and whatever. So I got enough to go on to make an entire video. Might not be within the first 2 weeks, but if I promise you guys get a video, you get a video no matter how long it takes. So after that, he told me, well, maybe it's better to wait for a little while. And I was like, why? He told me that they were working on their first full-length album, and I'm glad I waited, because this album is really fucking good. It's called Malevolence. It's brought out by Cyclone Empire. It has 10 songs on it, and I will show you guys the CD itself. This is the front of the booklet of the CD. Really cool artwork with, again, the Bodyfarm logo, of course, and Malevolence. Really cool. The inside of the booklet contains lyrics, which are a little bit dark, so you really need some extra light to read all those lyrics. And then there's, of course, a picture in the middle of the guys. And the one who looks the prettiest over there, that's Thomas Wouters, the vocalist. Really cool guy, really cool band, really good. And not to suck up to Thomas Wouters, I mean, but he has some really awesome vocals. In my opinion, actually, my kind of, my favorite kind of vocals. Not because it's understandable, because if you're trying, you can hear what he's saying, but it's really raw, raspy, overwhelming, really deep. Really good. And I really love the music. They make old school death metal, not really in the style of Dismember or Unleashed or stuff like that. But I think that old school death metal fits their genre the best. So by now you heard music from Bodyfarm, you saw the video clip, and I must say I was really impressed with this album, Malevolence, from Bodyfarm. It's really good to see that there are Dutch guys who form a band and that understand how to make a very good, quality good, death metal album. I mean, just like I said in this video, I get a lot of stuff sent to me, and a lot of people send me messages to their Facebook and to music, and I go like, maybe you guys need to listen more to the music you like and try to have a better recording. I mean, this is just one of those jewels in your closet. And I'm not sucking up, this is just what I think. Just like the guys from IKOS, they bring out the first album and it just blows you away. And that's the same with this Bodyfarm. It's just an awesome album. And I think that bands like this, bands such as Bodyfarm, have the potential to become as big as Dutch legends such as Gorefest and Sinister. Gorefest is a band that unfortunately does not longer exist, which was really good. And Sinister does still exist. They brought out a new album quite recently, which from the top of my head is called Carnage Ending. I'll just put a link so you can check it out. And of course, all the links to Bodyfarm. It's really good to see that there are still bands out there that think, you know, fuck all this mainstream shit, fuck all the same sounding shit, we're gonna bring out a quality album. And in my opinion, Malevolence is high fucking quality. Guys, very good work. And to you guys, go check these guys out. They're from the Netherlands, another band to be proud of, and which makes you proud to be Dutch. Thank you very much for sending it to me. It's a jewel in my collection, and I'll just put it up, and I'll just kick Baldrick's ass for screwing up. Thomas and all the other guys, thank you very much for this album. Keep up the good work, and I'll see you guys next video.
good video.
Shut up, Baldrick.